I've been doing animal studies work, acting classes, and playing around with how that influences your characters. In fact, my character on 12 Monkeys, her name originally was Mantis. I think that's what it said in the announcement here, but they we renamed her. She has a real human name. But that was super fun for me because I got to think, oh, she's a praying mantis. And what is, how do they move? And how does that influence how you act, you know? I've got a couple of independent films I'm working on, and I guess waiting to see what happens with 12 Monkeys. They're deciding on, I've got a couple more episodes of that airing, and then waiting to see what happens with that, and, you know, see what comes down the pipeline.
I mean, if you did get to keep 12 Monkeys going in some fashion, what would you want to see for that?
Well, it's such a complicated, layered show. I don't even know. I just want to see whatever they come up with, because what they come up with is really great. And, I don't know if they'd go further back in time or how they would keep adding on to it. But what's so great is at the core of it is the human relationships that are going on. So you're caught in this chaotic traveling through time and trying to save the world. But what's really happening is, like, this is a love story. And so I think that, you know, that's the direction I would hope they continue to go in. It seems like that's the crux of it. And, you know, it's such a great show, too, because there's so many strong female roles. And it's getting a lot of great press about that, which is really awesome. So I would just hope they keep going with that. You know, it is what it is. And I'm glad that there is movement from 12 Monkeys. I would hope more shows will embrace that, because, and I, you know, I don't know what, why it is that is the way. But women are complicated and strong and powerful, just like men. And it's nice that we're moving in a direction, I think, hopefully in the world in general, it seems, but you know, it's important to have characters in that future fantasy, whatever world you're going to be in the sci-fi world, who are role models for women. And I think it's nice to see come to the convention and see so many women excited to be here. And I'm sure it's nice for them to have characters that they're like, oh, that's a woman. I can have a voice in that. You know, even in the tech world, it's thought of as a male-centric world. And there's so many women who are, you know, breaking into that world and making names for themselves. And I think wherever, in whatever genre of entertainment, it's important that women's roles are layered and complicated. And I hope we can keep getting more female directors and female writers and producers and opening up and expanding that possibility, because I think that will reflect back into society and what young girls are watching, or, you know, young women or old ladies, whatever.